name is David, and I'm a violinist with the Oakville Symphony Orchestra. Hello, my name is David, and I'm a violinist with the Oakville Symphony Orchestra. What's going on here? I'm here to shoot a video. Well, that's what I'm doing. You are? Well, why don't we work together? Sounds good. David, and I've been playing the violin since I was 4 years old. That's a pretty long time, but it's not as long as my violin has been around. My violin was made by an Italian named Pietro Floriani in the year 1854, which means it's about 165 years old. The violin is a member of the string family, which in a symphony orchestra also includes the viola, the cello, and the double bass, and if you're really lucky, even a harp or two. The piano is not considered a string instrument. It's more properly known as a keyboard instrument, but there are many, many other string instruments, such as the guitar, the erhu, vina, dulcimer, balalaika, bandura, banjo, bouzouki, mandolin, lyre, koto, oud, ukulele, lute, sitar, tambura, zither, oh my goodness, and many, many more. Like most string instruments, the violin is basically a hollow wooden box. What? Whoa. So why does the violin sound so much better than just a plain old wooden box? Has four strings on it, and when you take the bow, which is a wooden stick with horse's hair on it, and you pull it across the string, the vibration of the string travels through the wooden bridge to the top of the violin, through the sound post inside to the back, and it's through all of this elaborate vibrating that makes the violin sound so beautiful. So what is it that makes the violin so unique? I mean, it can't play as many notes as the piano can. Wow, I wouldn't even want to try that. And the violin can't play as loudly as the trombone can. Thanks, Bob.
You're welcome.
And the violin lacks that deep, rich sonority that the viola has. Wow, that was beautiful. Thanks, Steph.
You're welcome.
And for sure, the violin can't play nearly as high as the piccolo can. Wow. Thanks, Anya.
You're welcome, David.
You know, it's so great that as a violinist, I have many musician friends who I can call on. All four of us are professional musicians and teachers within the Greater Toronto Area, and we love to make music together. One of the things that the violin does really well is it can play music that's extremely passionate. Violin can do very well is it can play music that's very fast and joyful and exciting. Was an exciting piece? Well, that's not all the violin can do. The violin is also really good at playing music that's slow and beautiful, and sometimes even a little bit sad. One of my favorites. It's so slow and peaceful and beautiful, but also a little bit melancholy. In fact, the violin is so versatile, and one composer even used it to represent the call of birds. You, but I thought that music was delicious. I mean, beautiful. Sometimes my students ask me what it is that I like best about playing the violin, and I tell them that there are three things that I love about playing the violin. The first one is that in any pursuit that's very difficult and worthwhile, so for example, probably some of you take piano lessons, or you study dance, or you do gymnastics, or you're a great soccer player, or you're the most amazing video game player. Whatever it is, it's important to have something that's difficult to do, that's a big challenge, and you work really hard at it over a number of years. And that feeling of satisfaction and pride that you're doing a good job and that you're getting better, that's the first thing that I love about playing the violin. And then I tell them that the second thing I love is how playing the violin and making music brings me together with other people. When I play in an orchestra, and there are almost 100 musicians all together on stage, working with one mind to produce music that reaches an audience, there's no better feeling in the world. And then the third thing that I love about playing the violin is that it connects me to music that was written sometimes hundreds of years ago by people who have been gone for a long time. But through their music, I can see that they had the same feelings, the same joys, and the same fears sometimes, the same ideas that we have today. And this gives me a feeling of unity, both with history and what it means to be human. That's what I love about playing the violin. Thank you so much for listening to my video today. I'd like to thank Oakville Community Classrooms and the Oakville Symphony for sponsoring this video. And I'd like to thank you for listening and watching so carefully. I would like to leave you with one of the greatest pieces ever written for the violin by a real virtuoso composer by the name of Michele Giacconi. And this is Abile Criminale. Thank you.